just some of the reactions that went through my mind over the last week as I saw you in your droves leaving comments on last week's vlog. Amazing. I mean, nearly 200 people left comments. And I know you were all sort of drawn there by my sparkling personality and fantastic book recommendations, and not just simply by the gorgeous Virginia Woolf collection that I was giving away. Yes, all of those books to one lucky subscriber. But whatever reason brought you here, I don't care. I just hope that you'll stick around. If you're new to this channel, I'm here every Friday talking about the books that have got me very, very excited here at Vintage, and indeed beyond Vintage, talking about books that I'm just excited about, because frankly, who's got time for anything else? Let's just talk about the good books. So anyway, amazing response last week. Lots of people who read Virginia Woolf and had recommendations about where I should go next. Lots of people who were like me, a bit scared, not quite sure where to go or, you know, which book to read first. And lots of love for those particular editions, which are gorgeous. If you're not the person who's going to win these books, go to a bookshop, find them, pick them up, touch them, stroke them, put them against your cheek, rub them. Don't get too much more intimate than that because you will be ejected from the bookshop, but just to have a look at them because they really are gorgeous. And you'll see that, like those and the Brontes and the Austins, we are making these lovely collections of classics. The Russians will be coming soon, and they're just gorgeous. They look beautiful on the shelf, but they're the kind of thing that you want to pick up and touch and just look at, and you know, that's what books are about. So just get in there, enjoy them. I did have a complete set to give away. One lucky person is going to win them, and that person is Josh at the Madhouse. Congratulations, Josh. You were the lucky name out of the hat. It was a big hat because there were a lot of names in there, but you are the one that came out. So congratulations. You will find my email address at the bottom of this video's description. Send me your postal address and I'll get all those books off to you as soon as I can. This week, I'm talking about graphic novels again. I'm talking about one in particular, and I'm also going to sort of quickly mention another couple as well, one which is upcoming and one which is out already. This is the one that I want to talk to you about mainly. This is Cormorance by Nick Hayes. Nick Hayes is a beautiful artist and illustrator, and his first book was The Rime of the Modern Mariner, and his last book was all about Woody Guthrie. And I really love his illustration. You may have seen it in newspapers or magazines before. But this book is really quite special because it is a graphic novel that has no words. It is a sort of a silent piece. Well, it's not silent, actually. There is noise in there. And you'll hopefully be able to see some of that when I flash up some pictures. But it has no text. So it's a bit like sort of watching a silent movie. It's all done through gesture, through facial expression, and through the amazing movement that he creates in his panels. Nick Hayes has a real engagement with the natural world. If you've read The Rime of the Modern Mariner, you'll know that that had a very kind of ecological message. It was all about pollution in the seas and things like that. And Woody Guthrie was all about music, but had a very, again, a very strong focus on the dust bowl of 1930s America, poverty, the lack of food and resources and all that kind of stuff. And this book, Cormorance, is about two people discovering each other. And it's also about the natural world, particularly about water and about birds in the sky. And it's the kind of thing where I sort of almost don't want to say anything about it because I don't want to spoil your enjoyment of reading it. It is a work of art in a way that sometimes comics or graphic novels might not be. And what I mean by that is that it's sort of, it's almost so much more than just simply a story on a page. It's the kind of thing that you could spend a very, very long time looking at. And it's quiet because it doesn't have that text. And so I found whilst reading it, I wanted to be somewhere quiet myself and to just really give myself the time to look at it and to enjoy the page. There is something that happens to your brain as your eye goes very slowly over a page of images. And we live in a very fast world, and I particularly am often reading books very, very quickly so that those words are whipping past as fast as possible. And actually taking a bit of time, allowing those images to soak in, is almost meditative. It's really good for you, and so I'm glad I did it. It has amazing gatefold-like pull-out pages that open out into these amazing sort of not even double, like quadruple page spreads. Just a beautiful, beautiful thing. And hopefully you'll have seen from the images that I've popped up, really beautiful illustrations. Even the palette of colours that he uses is very, very calming. And it's a touching story, because the reason for both of these people to find each other, or why it's important, is because they've both suffered loss in some way. So it's just a beautiful thing. I'm hoping that at some point soon I'm going to be able to go to where Nick works and to make one of my home visits videos. I don't have it ready yet, so I can't give you a link now. Unless you're watching this in the future sometime and looking back, in which case I would have added the link and it would have appeared somewhere here by now. Anyway, that is Cormorance by Nick Hayes, and it is just gorgeous and out now. The other one I want to mention that's out now is this, Notes on a Thesis by Tiffane Rivière, who is a French writer. And basically, if you have ever been at university, whether you've done a degree or a master's or a PhD, she's doing a PhD in this. If you've ever suffered any kind of exam or essay anxiety, then you are going to want to read this book, because it is just steeped in the world of academia and all of the frustrations and anxieties that go along with that. Now, actually, I didn't go or do a master's or a PhD of anything, so I don't know about that firsthand, but I can certainly see how funny that this book is, and how fraught her existence is in this book. It's incredibly funny and very French as well. There's something very French about this book. So that is definitely one, as I say, for pretty much anyone who's ever been to university and who enjoys a graphic novel. This is perfectly tailor-made for you. And the other one I want to mention that's coming up is Saving Grace by Grace Wilson. This is her first graphic novel with us. And it kind of focuses on three female flatmates who are all sort of trying to scrape by in London and working out what to do with their lives, basically. And Grace is an illustrator, and it's just incredibly funny. I think particularly well suited to any graphic novel readers who live in London or in a big city, but particularly London, because there's lots of sort of London-based gags here. But, you know, if you've lived in any big city where the rents are just insanely extortionate and landlords are unscrupulous and standards of living are pretty poor, you're going to understand all of the humour in this book. But also what I really like about it is that it's about people finding direction in their lives. And there's a really heartwarming thing for Grace in particular about how she finds not only a bit of direction in her life, but also the sort of the confidence and the support to get on with it and do what she really loves, which is to draw and to make people laugh. So that is Saving Grace. Again, I'm hoping that I'm going to get to go to where Grace works and to make a film with her and to talk to her about stuff. Again, if you're watching in the future, a link will probably have appeared just here, but it's not ready yet. So there you go, that's Saving Grace by Grace Wilson. Three books there. I have got copies of Cormorance to give away. Two copies to give away. So if you are a subscriber, leave a comment below and I will pick winners out of the hat next week. What am I talking about next week? I can't remember. You're just going to have to tune in and find out. But thank you, thank you, thank you to everybody who commented last week. Stick around. There's going to be good stuff every Friday. Those of you who've been here for the last year or so, you know how it works. You know there's the good stuff. So I will see you next week for more. Take care.